Hey everyone, my name is Lily and I'm the book blogger behind Utopia State of Mind, and if you didn't know, I'm obsessed with enamel pins. So I don't even remember like why I became obsessed with enamel pins. I want to say I've been obsessed for at least the last year, 2 years, maybe even three, like for a while. And so I had to actually reorganize my enamel pin collection, and I do this kind of somewhat like I do this maybe once every 6 months, so it's not super frequent, but I got some new pin hoops and I thought that I would reorganize them, and so I just wanted to take you along on the journey. Today I'm only going to be focusing on the contemporary pins that I have. I have them normally set up by genre, so I'm going to take you through the contemporary pins that I have. As far as if you want to know my vision for reorganizing, I want to keep the contemporary ones the same. But for my fantasy and sci-fi collection, what I want to do is take out the like owl crate, essentially, like take out the subscription box pins and like put them aside, and then either see if there's enough to put on its own hoop or decide if I organize them by genre as well. So I'm gonna be reorganizing all these other pin hoops, but I just wanted to show you like a brief overview essentially of what I mean before I dive into the contemporary pin hoops. So for example, this is my science fiction pin hoop. This is like part one of my fantasy pin hoops. I have a few fantasy pin hoops because I have just like a lot of fantasy pins essentially. And then part two of the fantasy pin hoop. And then the third one, which is basically fantasy pins as well, but like from basically only Darker Shade of Magic, Holly Black pins, and Leigh Bardugo pins essentially. So those are the pin hoops I have, and I'm going to be doing videos where I kind of reorganize those as well, so look out for those in the future if you like this one. But today I'm going to talk about my contemporary pin hoop, which has nothing in it. So just for in case anyone was wondering, I didn't like buy pre-made pin hoops just because that's just not like in my capability at the moment. So I made these with my mom. So I basically just got like embroidery pin hoops. I took the measurements for the fabric I'd need to have remainder, and also I kind of played around with how much I need, because obviously you need the pin, like the fabric, to go through that and to give you like a nice tension. But it's not backed, because I really wanted to be able to change the fabric. If you saw on the other ones, like all of those different fabrics, I went to a fabric store and I chose them. And then I made a variety of different like circles from different fabrics. So for example, with this orange and white chevron fabric, I have it in, I have like two small ones, I think, and two large ones. Just because when I was making the hoops, I've realized that I wanted to be able to change them. And also like, the more I change them, the more they'll get these little like, the holes in the pin hoops as well. So, you know, I just needed it for changeability factor. And also, as I said, they're not backed. So I feel like a lot of pin hoops have a lot of stability because they're backed, but these ones aren't, because I wanted to, as I said, be able to change them a lot. But in photos, what I like to do is just use like a piece of tape to put behind them and give that, like take away the edges essentially. Sorry, I'm just re-putting this hoop in to take away the edges. But you could obviously back this if you knew you wanted to keep the fabric. I just didn't really know, and I still don't really know what I'm gonna do. Just because I really like being able to change it up, and I also really like being able to use the different fabrics. By the way, I also have a pin hoop that is like just for random bookish related pins that aren't specifically for a specific book. So if you're interested in that, also let me know. I'm obsessed with enamel pins. This is a collection that I've been curating for like a really long time. And I hope that you enjoy this kind of, you know, this kind of video. And let's just dive into it. So I'm gonna be doing in-depth shots of each of the pins, so don't worry about that. And hopefully editing me will have figured out to like minimize myself and put bigger shots of the pins. I don't think I'm gonna actually put them like in the pin hoop live, because I need to do those shots. So I'm just gonna tell you a little bit of a story about the pin. One of the early pins I got was this Dumplin' pin. I think I got this at like a Epic Reads event or whatever when they did a swag bag. But I remember that was kind of when I didn't have a lot of pins. So it was certainly very old. I wanna say like maybe 2018 essentially. So yeah, when I was basically on the pin journey starting. And I really love this one because it's a metal pin. And as you'll see, I don't have a lot of the soft enamel pins because my personal preference are for metal enamel pins. So like hard metal, soft metal ones. I actually don't have like a soft metal one that I can even show you in comparison. But yeah, they're just softer. They're just softer. And they're also, I also feel like a little bit not as shiny because I think the material is a little bit different. So the metal ones are my preference. And yeah, so I really loved it. And also I was able to put my little dumpling pin next to these little pins I got as pre-orders for Puddin. So they are the two main characters from Puddin. Super, super cute. I love them so much. I love, like, I actually, these are my only people pins, I feel like. There's also my Ramona Blue pin. So actually all of my like Julie Murphy pins are all of people, which is super unique for my pin collection. So I really just enjoy seeing like tiny people in pins. It's super cute. And the Ramona Blue pin I actually got from, I think, a friend, because I was telling her how much I love enamel pins, and I think she was like, oh, by the way, I have a pre-order pin for Ramona Blue if you want it. And yeah, I did want it. I really love Julie Murphy's books, and I think they're just super cute. They're one of my favorite, like, Julie Murphy is one of my favorite contemporary authors. The next one is, it is a person pin, but it's like of a head, okay? That's why I didn't want to say it was like a people pin, because you don't see the whole body. But it was a pre-order pin incentive for I Want to Be Where You Are by Christina Forrest. You will notice I have a lot of pre-order pins. I'm one of those people who, like, if you say that there's a pre-order incentive for a pin, I'm like 8 to 9 times out of 10 going to pre-order that book. That's just where I am right now. But this one I actually did pre-order, whereas the other ones I don't think I did pre-order. So for the other pins that I've shown you already, I'm not sure if I pre-ordered those. I want to say that I did pre-order Puddin, but actually I don't think it's on my shelf, so I'm not really sure about that one. Maybe I like got it, and maybe I got it in a trade at that time. I don't use them anymore, but I used to use a lot of the like trading arcs for trade, swag for trade kind of thing. You'll see that's how I got a lot of the Owl Crate ones, because until this year I didn't have an owl, like I didn't have a subscription box at all, really. So that's how I was able to track down the Owl Crate Illumicrate, you know, like all of the crate pins that I wanted. So I think that's actually how I tracked down the Puddin pins as well. But anyway, I actually did pre-order I Want to Be Where You Are. It is right here, you can see it. And it's just so cute, and I knew that I wanted to read this book for a really long time, and I'm the worst, and I haven't read it yet. The next one, I also have a really cute story for. These are these, like, Texas Forever and Jolly Good pins. I won these in a giveaway. I won these in a giveaway from Casey McQuiston, who wrote Red, White, and Royal Blue, and these are Red, White, and Royal Blue themed pins. They're not, like, pre-order pins because they weren't created for the book, but they were just pins that I won from that giveaway, and they're just so precious to me because I really love Red, White, and Royal Blue, and I have the arc, so for a while I was just like so excited about both of those things essentially. And so the fact that it was a pin giveaway with the arc just like blew my mind. And so they're just super cute, and they're both like beverage themed pins. I love tea, so where can you really go wrong? Those are also my only adult romance pins. Would I love more adult romance pins? Yes. I would love more adult romance, fantasy, sci-fi. Like, I love more adult pins in general. I only have adult pins made by, like, other pin companies. So I'll talk about that because I have some Wayfarers pins, for example. But I would just love more, like, adult fantasy, sci-fi, romance pins in general, please. Okay. The next one was another pre-order pin. It's of this cute little food truck. And it was a pre-order pin for The Way You Make Me Feel, which I really loved. It has a food truck in it, which is why, like, the food truck is the pre-order pin, but it's also, like, just so fun, and I also don't, you have a lot of, you know, truck-related things, like, vehicle-related pins, but I don't know, it's just so fun and cute, and the color scheme for it is really adorable because it's this pinkish red, white, and blue, but it's all, like, pastel-toned, and Maureen Gu is another one of my favorite contemporary authors, so I just loved having like a pin to commemorate that. The next one I think I also won in a giveaway. It's for If You're Out There. It's just this little blue house, And I remember being so happy that I won the giveaway because I wasn't sure if I was going to enter the pre-order giveaway for the pin, I think, or like the pre-order incentive for the pin. And so then I won it. I think I won that in a, I won this like class of 2019 debuts essentially, because basically they did this incentive, which I thought was really cool, where if you review it on Goodreads and just everywhere and you have library requests or purchase request proofs, then you're entered into this like massive giveaway. And I won that because basically I like kept a record of all the books that I was going to review or read as ARCs and like purchase slash library requests as well, and made sure that I had little check boxes to make sure that I also submitted my proof of all of that stuff, and then I won that. So that was really fantastic. I love how this is just turning into a giant story time. The next one I got actually from the publisher. This is this little cat. I don't know if this little tiger, this cat, it's a tiger. I don't know if this tiger pin was created specifically for the campaign for We Are the Wildcats. I think it probably was not. It also came with a field hockey pin, which I don't know where that is. I don't know where that is, but anyway, it came as a little promo box for We Are the Wildcats, and that was really cute because the as you can tell from the title, Wildcats, so they took this little tiger. As I said, I don't think this was necessarily made specifically for We Are the Wildcats. The next one is another one of those, my friends know that I love enamel pins. I'm pretty sure I got this one from Dana. It's funny because Dana and I met when, like, IRL, and then didn't even realize that we were both kind of blogger people until after when we were talking about it. So I really love looking back at, like, the start of Dana and my friendship. But Dana heard that I love enamel pins, and she was like, hey, I have this ice cream cone pin from Stay Sweet. Do you want it? And I was like, yes, I do. I don't want to keep saying I don't have a lot of blah pins. But, you know, ice cream is a food. And actually, though, now that I say that, I do have another ice cream pin because my friend gave it to me and she was like, this is my favorite ice cream store and they also do pins. So I thought you would really enjoy it. I've gotten a lot of really fun pin gifts from people. And it's definitely something I want to feature in like a future pin reorganization slash pin collection video, because I just really love telling the stories about how I found these pins or how I got them. And I don't really have that many opportunities to, because I feel like in photos you'll see an overview of maybe my pin board or my pin hoop, but I don't really get to talk about the specific journey to the pin, right? The pin's journey to me, but that's this pin's journey. Next one is another pre-order pin. I forgot the title of this book. I think it's The Birds, the Bees, and something else. I'll obviously leave it like around the screen essentially, but I loved it because this A was such, I think I got this as a library request too, so I didn't have to pre-order it, but I read an arc of it and the book was so sex positive and the contemporary world was, yes, just so sex positive, so I loved that book so much, and that specific element, super feminist, super sex positive, and it was just really great. And like there was this bird pin, there was this B pin, and also a menstrual pad, which I think I gave to my friend because she saw it and was like, oh, I really love that, essentially. I think I got this pin. I honestly can't remember because I, like, obviously will want to document kind of this stuff in the future, but past me didn't know that they were going to start a YouTube video channel, didn't know that they were going to, like, ever talk about the pins they got, essentially. So that's the story of this pin. Also, it's super cute little like pastel colored bee. The next one is a pre-order, the pre-order incentive pin for Frankly in Love with Books. This is a pre-order incentive pin for Frankly in Love by David Yoon, not Frankly in Love with Books. Like, it just took basically the title treatment for the cover and then added with books. It was super cute, and it was funny because I got to do a post from Penguin where they asked me to do a creative post, and they sent me a copy of the ARC, which is really great. But what I decided to do was a post of this plus a nail look, which was really fun because I don't do nail things at all. You can find that on my blog. I will link it below. But it was just really fun, and I bought new nail polish for it, and I did it with a friend. And I was like, do you have this color nail polish? And she said yes, and then she helped me take the photos. And so I just have so many nostalgic memories for that. And I also did some photos of my nails with the pin. So that's why I'm thinking about it, essentially. The next one is another pre-order incentive pin, and it is for Summerbird Blue. I have loved all of Kemi Dawn Bowman's books, Starfish, Summerbird Blue, the Harley in the Sky. Those are three of my favorite, and Kemi Dawn Bowman is one of my favorite contemporary authors. It's this cute little ukulele, and it has the initials of the two main characters, or not the two main characters, but the main character and her sister. And Summerbird Blue is a lot about queer identity, but also about grief and loss. So in general, this is just such a nostalgic pin, not only because I love the author, but because I've read the book, so I realized the significance of the pin. The next one is this pin for On the Come Up, which is so funny because I post a lot about pins. I don't know if you knew. Recently, I haven't been posting as much about pins on Instagram just because I have had like a lot of ideas for books, but I'm going to post more about pins, I promise. But I was meeting up at the Frankfurt Book Fair with a publicist who works at Walker Books, and I met up with her to chat and meet in person. So it's really great when I can meet like people that I've worked with a lot virtually, and then I can meet them in person. And it was really fun because she was like, hey, I know you love pins. So she gave me this one, which I don't know if it was like a pre-order incentive thing. I love how the UK is doing a lot more pre-order incentive pins. I just don't live in the UK, so I can't like enter them, but I've really loved some of the pins they've done. And so it was really great. I love when people like think of me and they think that I love pins, or like they make that connection. It's really cute. If I had to think about things that I want to be known for, that aren't books, enamel pins, definitely. Tea is another one. That might be it. I mean, I really love cats. I don't have a cat, but I really love cats. And I don't know, I've been starting to play a lot more Among Us. Like, I can't think of the basically third one, but the first two have to be enamel pins and tea. The next one could be my very first enamel pin, and it was a pin for The Astonishing Color of After by Emily X. Arpan. That is one of my all-time favorite books. I have the US and the UK copy, and I made such great relationships because of people who love that book. I remember I went to the book launch for The Astonishing Color of After, and I met a really good friend, and we've stayed in touch ever since, and we've met up, and it's just like, I love, okay, first off, we haven't done like in-person book events in so long, but this is one of the reasons why I've loved them. I've met some really, really great people who have been like longtime friends since then, essentially, at book events. I met the person that I'm talking about at one of the Astonishing Color of After launches, and we like met up essentially every time I was in town. And then I met another friend who was like the first other adopted Asian person that I'd met like ever in person at a Celeste Ng event. So like, I've had so many really great book event experiences, I guess. And so it just makes me like think this book, The Astonishing Color of After, is just so nostalgic to me because of that, essentially. And the pin and the book are all really nostalgic because it was such like a magical book about grief and identity. And it was also one where like Emily X. Arpan did this thing for the pre-order campaign where if you pre-ordered it, she would send you all of the swag and stuff early. And so that meant that you could take photos with this like postcard and like to promote the book and do a lot of photos and like all sorts of stuff. And so I did, because I'd read an ARC and I loved it. And so I took a lot of photos on Instagram for The Astonishing Color of After with the pin and with some cranes that my mom has a statue of, and just a bunch of different things. And then I won like this additional giveaway, and that was the whole point, right? If you promoted the book a lot, then you could be entered to win, you know, your promotional things were like entered as an entry. And then I won that, and that was really great. And I won a lot of like cute little goodies. But yeah, that's just why this whole book and like that whole experience is just so nostalgic for me, and it's why I really love this pin. And the next one are like all Samira Ahmed books. And the first one has to be my most recent contemporary pin acquisition. And it's this Mad, Bad, and Dangerous to Know pre-order pin, Mad, Bad, and Dangerous to Know, one of my favorite books. One of my favorite books from 2020, essentially. And it released last year. It's this fantastic contemporary, but it's also like mixes not archaeological, but it mixes like adventuring, sleuthing, detectiving, looking at the untold stories of women throughout history and in art, and it's just fantastic. And so I pre-ordered that. I knew I loved it like so much, and I got a pin for it. I really love when I think I'm gonna love a book and then I do love that book. It's just one of the best feelings, essentially, to know that you are right. I love this little hat pre-order pin for Internment. It was really cute because I did this one photo on Instagram. I'll try to link it if I can find it, where I made it seem like I was, you know, wearing the hat essentially, and it was just really fun, and it was one of my favorite like Instagram photos that I've taken because I had to get a lot of help, and it was just a lot of fun to do that shoot. And then when I was at YALC, or YALC, Young Adult Litter, I don't know what it stands for, but when I was at YALC UK, then I was able to get this Read to Resist pin, which was the UK pre-order related pin for Internment. So I was able to get like both of them side by side, and so I really love that. And that brings me to the end of all of the contemporary pins. I'm just like looking down to make sure I didn't forget any. All of the contemporary pins and all the reasons why I love them and like the stories behind them. So if you love this kind of video, please let me know so I can know to film more of them. I have a lot of pins I can film more of. I have a lot of them. We could do this basically for a really long time. And then I can also keep you updated about new pins that I've acquired. So yeah, just let me know if you really like this, and tell me if you have a favorite pin, or also if you have a favorite like non-bookish hobby. I'll see you in the next one. Bye!